So what drew me to multiple sclerosis? I think early when I was training in neurology, the neurology wards are usually filled with elderly patients who have chronic strokes or chronic illnesses. But the patients with MS were young, dynamic, in the middle of their careers, and they used to come in for their high-dose steroids over the weekend. So if you're a busy professional and you had MS, you would come into the hospital Friday night and begin 3 days of high-dose steroids monitored in the hospital Friday night, Saturday, and Sunday, so you could go to work Monday morning. And I got to know those patients really well, and at that time, there were no treatments. No FDA-approved treatment for multiple sclerosis. And I think that's the first thing that drew me. The second thing that drew me is I began to interview at the National Institutes of Health to do fellowships. And the group back then, the neuroimmunology branch, was brand new and filled with just very young, dynamic, interesting scientists. And I think that kind of closed the loop for me that that's what I knew I wanted to do.